Welcome back to our Sonic Adventure 2 Extraordinaire Experience. We are now finally going back to the hero story, where Tails came in.
Let's see how Tails is going to be.
It's a secret military base that is reinforced and super strong. It's called Prison Island. I heard the news about it on satellite TV.
Your ventriloquism skills are amazing.
Or rob the bank.
This has been a problem for Sonic Adventure 1.
I'm on my way.
Like, yeah, they are lip-syncing this more for the Japanese one. Which is really ironic. The ironic thing is, remember, this one was actually being made in America, though. Like, you think at this point Sega would have realized Sonic was definitely more of interest in America. Like, I think only really starting with Frontiers has the story first been made in English.
Well, as you yourself said in a previous part, there's a certain gentleman that was at the time the head of Sonic.
Also,
insisted on
in the team hero version, Tails literally ambushes Eggman out of nowhere.
Yes.
Alan, the PS1 Crash Bandicoot game had better lip syncing than this from different language versions. That's because Naughty Dog had lip sync different depending on what version of the game you were playing.
We can assume that the same cutscene that happened in Team Dark happened. It's just that this shows how Tails showed up in time to save Amy.
Don't you see, Tails? Eggman is a bad guy, so it's
this
okay.
This time I'll let you go, but the next time we meet, you
go
won't
easy
be so
on him,
lucky.
Tails. He misses his wife. For the love of God, don't tell him what Shadow did to her.
Wow, Tails, you did it! But what are you doing?
I knew one of us was gonna start
the one
that.
Who should be asking that question.
You know what? I can appreciate that fandom for definitely resurging Sonic Adventure 2's popularity. And thankfully, in a good way for the most part.
I love Tails' expression of not this shit again.
Also, you gotta love how it's the 8-year-old who tells you it's too dangerous here. Alright! Let's hit Prison Lane.
Find the core of the prison.
Oops, sorry, Omocho.
The mighty forces of Gun, ported by an 8-year-old.
I mean,
genius 8-year-old.
True, yeah, one who's able to match wits with the same doctor who made fools of the military in not one but two levels. 3 for counting Lost Colony, 4 for counting
Honestly,
Hidden Base.
Combined also with the stuff that it was mentioned before about the gun having multiple, you know, secret weapons and also what we will learn later, I'm pretty sure the game at this point is pretty taking the piss out of the United States government and overzealousness over many things.
This was at a time where technically gun were definitely a military force, but not confirmed to be the American military force, but they were definitely... Okay, let me put it like this. You know how, like, Hydra were made to be Nazis, but, oh, you don't have to say the dreaded Nazi word? Gun were, like, a sect of the American military, but totally meant to represent the American military without poking the nose too much. Wait, hold on, that was Big. What the hell is Big doing in the Slammer?
He got arrested for tax fraud.
That or Froggy finally put that restraining order in
so
action.
I got it. That's why Big was looking for Froggy. It's not because Froggy is his best mate. It's because Froggy was going to blab about Big, skipping his tax returns.
Man, Big was never the same after the divorce.
Yeah, let's move on.
Let's not go there because
Vanilla before Vector?
The only other cat in the series is a bit too young for that.
Wasn't Vector actually going for Kree's mother?
That is Vanilla.
Oh, I get it.
Cream, vanilla.
No, I deserve something else.
And cheese.
And chocolate, yeah. But Cloud Webs, to be fair, the way age works in the Sonic universe clearly is very different than how human age works. So for all we know, maybe it's okay for Blaze and Vic to be affected.
You know, I love that gem.
In recent years, this series has done away with ages entirely because it just creates too many problems.
They decided, okay, age is causing too much of a problem, so let's abolish the concept of age.
Age doesn't exist.
All the more reason then.
I was gonna mention in the final post instead, but in the more recent, it's only recently that I discovered that apparently Rouge is still supposed to be roughly the age of the other cast and it's not supposed to be older. Because honestly, the more, you know, older boys, Femme Fatale kind of impression, I think actually fits more the character design.
Actually, going off of the Sonic Heroes manual, Rouge is supposed to be one of the older cast members, even older than Knuckles.
18. She's 18 too.
Well, that's still not much. I was thinking more like, about at least 25.
Sonic? Yeah, Sonic, like, this series cannot convince me. This series cannot convince me that she is 18.
Sonic,
she's definitely someone in their late 20s.
Well, Sonic doesn't know how to get out of a prison cell.
Well, especially during the Four Kids era of game series.
Like, Sonic, mate, you demolished a robot before which was made of metal. Bend those bars like Beckham, come on.
Actually, these are the one bars that Gunn were able to reinforce enough.
Are you sure?
In Sonic X, they kind of did the sort of smart thing of putting it underwater.
The reason I'm in here is because of that fake hedgehog.
You mean that black hedgehog?
You know, did you considering see it? Where is the, it now? The original plot of Streets of Rage 3 was butchered severely, this is lightly similar, only that the imposter here is not a robot.
That black hedgehog came here with Dr. Eggman.
So, Eggman's behind this, huh?
Well, you're just
what's
swatting
all
a fly,
writing on the wall anyway?
Yes.
I really want to wonder why the mocap patter suddenly did that. Wait for me, Sonic! He's such
a brother. I'll give it credit, this one
is weirded out by why he does
ten,
that.
10 bucks says Yuji Naka told him to be super expressive.
You know what? That tracks. Go, Hanjo.
Oh god, right. Metal Harbor.
Welcome to Metal Harbor. It's a fun stage when you know how to ace it, but it is arguably one of the hardest stages to ace.
Not necessarily, are more frustrating. The opening attack is actually cool, I have to admit, because you're basically free to explore with that.
Yeah,
but I gotta be honest, the whole thing about the light ring button being assigned makes this very, you know, frustrating, to actually land correctly. And more probably
that's
more...
Why I gave, that's why I gave Job a mod to map it to the triangle button.
Also, more potential afterburner Easter eggs. And also, what we're about to get is that at the end of the stage, they want to throw a curveball with a time limit.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, okay, this is definitely a stage that tests all your skills, essentially. And if you have all the power-ups, you can make a pretty cool episode of Sonic Movement out of this. Tight!
One thing that I don't particularly care about in SA2 compared to SA1 is how they nerfed the spin dash.
And
I really like how
here we go!
The spin. Yeah, here we go.
Hi!
Yep! Gunn decided, let's launch a missile to kill this hedgehog.
In 15 seconds.
But you know what? Screw the lower handle, we're going for the higher one.
I can't believe the Captain America left the game. Did actually had a bonus level it was based on
you
this.
You're cutting it a bit closer, Jared.
Doing this bit.
We're almost at the end.
Doing this bit is actually the only way you can get an S. I'm sorry, an A rank in this effort.
Actually, also I forgot.
I keep forgetting
this
that
level,
this game didn't have S ranks. Yet.
Was this level? What the fuck? Oh, okay. Yep. Was this level present in the 3DS version of Generations? I forgot.
No.
Okay, I got confused with something else.
Also, it is possible, but very hard to get the A rank without getting the top handle rocket.
The SA2 stage that they put in 3DS Generations was the first Shadow stage.
Radical.
Although, I'll be honest, even though it is possible to get an A rank without getting the top handle, it's always the most satisfying to do it with the top handle.
Oh, here's one of the more iconic scenes.
Yep.
Of course.
So far, so good. Hey, that's...
That blue hedgehog again, of all places.
I found you. Faker! Faker? I think you're the fake hedgehog around here. You're comparing yourself to me? Huh? You're not even good enough to be
I'll
my
I'll make you eat those words!
That hey, you ain't even let me
truly,
finish!
That is totally...
the great banter, but...
Well,
truly,
the great... makes sense. Yeah, the best gets angry and he immediately goes for it. That
truly,
the, doesn't make sense.
The best banter is rivaled by the three small children.
I love how Shadow's so first response to getting hit is saying that he is the coolest. For an
imposter. That's really
you need to maintain appearances.
I'm the coolest.
And Sonic clearly taunts on his corpse.
Yeah.
having Shadow say, man, I'm cool verbally, is the same thing as having Batman say it. Like, it feels.
I'm fine with it since it does establish that Shadow is still cocky in a sense. Also, thanks, Eggman.
Part of the appeal of the meme in the first place is the fact that he cuts him off, so.
Yeah.
Like, keep it.
And it's totally in character for Sonic to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, you're right.
Definitely. He does it several times. I did try to say this during the last stage, but. I played Heroes PS2 before this, even though this came out first. Heroes PS2 has forever made me paranoid about using the homing attack over a bottomless pit on anything.
Yeah. I get it.
Yeah, I mean, I actually played both Heroes and Shadow the Hedgehog before truly knowing what even happened in the adventure games, honestly. Which, in a sense, did help a certain twist in Adventure 2 really catch me off guard, but I won't say what that twist is
also,
just yet.
What kind of mold or fungi cultivation gun was having on this island? Because holy shit, the air is full of spores.
One has to wonder if there was a civilization here, since in Shadow's counterpart level, there are lit torches and everything.
I'm gonna say remnants of the kidnaps, we have a tendency to do this shit.
Well, there won't be a civilization in 7 minutes.
Yep, that's right, you got a countdown.
You say that, and yet for reasons that are never explained, this island is mysteriously intact in Shadow the Hedgehog.
Well, to be fair, it is clearly in ruins. So, to give him credit, it's like, I mean, yeah, the island's intact, population on it, not so much.
Okay, but how come all the buildings still look intact in that level, though?
I mean, they look wrecked overall, and again, you know, don't underestimate some metallurgy. Again, the main...
I don't even remember if I actually went to that level.
Okay, the Shadow the Hedgehog game does go on to state that the place is obviously past its better days. And like, you know, it's not unusual for metal structures to remain after an explosion, albeit a bit tattered.
Like, the closest I can imagine would be Gun getting back there to actually excavate, you know, stuff that they could salvage from
Ooh,
their base.
Oh!
Bungee jumpy, cool, dude.
Leave it to Gun to, of course, still put robots in the way.
Yeah, that's also another thing. There aren't, I don't think there are any major bad nicks in this game.
Oh, there are. They show up later.
Okay, must have forgot them. Sonic, you wanna move? There you go.
I was trying to look cool for the moment.
Like, it's much faster if you run.
But it looks cool when I grind on vines. Also,
you're Sonic, you're the fastest thing alive. And there we go.
Mm-hmm. And yes, Dribs, as you pointed out, I do have all the power-ups beforehand. This is because, you know, again, got the power-ups beforehand. The cool thing is you can go back and, in story cutscenes, all your power-ups will show up
that
on the characters.
Cool.
Hence why Knuckles is rocking some cool sunglasses. I guess to give credit to Prison Island, it's only the forest section we come back to, because, yeah, elsewhere, that'd be down.
How did the U.S. government, you know... Oh, here we go.
Oh, yeah. There's no time to lose.
I have
have to hurry and find the Master Emerald.
Okay, welcome to
things are still relatively okay here, at least.
Yeah.
Is the gimmick of Knuckles dealing with the supernatural thing that started here, or was something that happened before?
I mean
Ghost, specifically of the supernatural variety.
Technically started as early as Sonic 3 and Knuckles. Because if you recall, Ghost showed...
True.
Yeah, Ghost showed up in the desert level. And while Sonic accidentally releases them, Knuckles has to deal with them when they're already let go. But yeah, this is Pumpkin Hill, easily my favorite treasure hunting stage in the game, and... yeah, has my favorite rap, too.
It's anything just for the song itself.
Yep. Also, I'd argue that this one uses its gimmick relatively well without driving you up a wall, in the sense that, hey, even with the GIMP radar, I could still have fun here. What doesn't help out so much is the camera! Let me get it! No, you stupid train!
Let me guess, there isn't a mod to help you fix the camera.
That's the thing about the cameras.
Cameras are unfortunately
the entire camera system. It's way more complicated than
And I'll give a credit
that,
to
I
will give a credit to Adventure 2. This was around the time where, again, 3D gameplay was still relatively new, and you know, camera work with that, unless it was, you know, super fixed, wasn't always the best.
Yes, you're right.
The emerald being in midair did not help any.
It was just, you know, close enough to be annoying, but too powerful to be actually effective,
Oh, by the way, fun fact though, kudos to Hunip for these raps here, because according to a video interview, he was given one day to write and record his material for the game. That includes the remix for Knuckles, I guess, as well.
So I guess you can make these almost improvised.
Going off of some...
Also, where he's actually being in this stage, I know one of his cameos is actually here.
He shows up in one of the gates and creepily peers behind you with his glowing yellow eyes.
Of course.
I could have maybe tried to find him, but I was trying to prioritize getting an A rank.
Yeah, getting an A rank.
But,
you do use an int, so you already kind of... You know,
I accidentally used a hint because I was punching it, and I guess it was close enough to the monitor that it registered as a hint, since I was already close anyway.
It's closer.
I mean, it did mention sleep behind the pumpkin, so there you go. Oh, actually, no.
Not that far behind, I guess.
There it is.
Okay.
I don't know, it's still... It's kind of charming.
Yeah, this is perfect!
Yeah.
I've come to make an announcement.
Yes, he has.
And you'll notice that the FMV has subtitles, even though in the vanilla version it doesn't.
Also,
child's creepy eyes.
Also, I love those words in the background. I am a genius. I am perfect. Robotnik.
Just because Eggman doesn't really have anything that is called subtlety or, you know, not having an ego.
So here's the arc in
He's
all
frequently
of its
made
glory.
Statues with his likeness.
Speaking
like,
of which,
if it wasn't made by him, still features his face.
Yeah, that's pretty convenient. I don't know if Gerald Robotnik intended that, but it works.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that was Gerald. I
mean. Oh boy, here we go. Time to get the plot element that the franchise loves to forget.
The moon, what, pissing on the moon?
Pissing on the moon.
The modern Samuel 555V made this special awesome mod to the movie files that has subtitles in them. Because for some reason, the FMVs are not subtitled.
I don't even understand. It's such a critical moment for this game and the franchise as a whole. Why did they keep, you know, pretending it never happened, or do the stupid shit of saying there are two moons or something?
But don't you see, Tails? Izuka gave us the answer to that. You see what happens with Tails? Every time you see the moon after this game, it turns. You're seeing the other side of the moon, so you can't see that part.
How is it possible with Dragon Ball has better excuses of why the moon is not present than Tails?
It's Izuka's Fujibayashi moment. But,
Tails is a Chaos Emerald. Don't worry, why he has one does get explained in the Dark Side story.
So it's not he's got it off screen.
Sonic,
you're making things worse for yourself.
Nah, Sonic.
Take care of the police.
Okay. Sonic is having his ice cube moment.
Okay, here's the thing, Dribs. Sonic and Mario can both boast that in their second 3D entry, they were framed for the crimes of a literal shadow version of themselves here. The thing is, while Mario just sat down and let the corrupt legal system have its way, Sonic don't play that way. He's gonna rebel every way he can to save the day, because Sonic.
He's always been rebelling against this things.
Well, that's also the thing, though. Sonic will focus on doing what's right. As we pretty much hammer home in Sonic and the Black Knight, Sonic does not care about always looking the hero, essentially. Especially if that's going to get in the way of doing what's right. So in this sense, he's like, yes.
Yeah, think of it like with Robin Hood, for example.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Pedro?
No, see, okay, see, here's the thing. I'm going to have a more proper talk slash rant about this.
Sure you won't, Shalmuchel, sure you won't.
You won't, yeah, sure you won't. I'm going to have a more proper talk slash rant about this when we get to my Shadow the Hedgehog run. But for now, I'll just say this. I'll just say this and let it rest for now. Izuka, no. The moon did not fucking turn. The real reason is because you guys were all like, oh, what are we gonna do? Are we gonna have the moon blown in half for every game from this put on? Fuck it. We'll just leave. I'm sure no questions will ever be asked.
You don't even have to just mention that it's like if it causes a plot point, like say, oh, it changes the title. You don't even have to do that. My suspicion is, but you can believe, just pissing on the moon, as the memes basically said, just change it, on a physical level. That's all you have to do. Make the model look with a crater. That's it.
There has been some intel that's come up about this. There was some things we already know. I'll start with that. One thing to keep in mind, when this game was made, there were legit thoughts that this was going to be the last Sonic game, period. Since, unfortunately, for as great as Adventure 2 was, it wasn't enough to stop the powerhouse that was the PS2 from pretty much taking the Dreamcast to church and all that. And the Dreamcast was doing good against the PlayStation 1, but when the PlayStation 2 came about, you all know how that story ended. So, so the dealio is like, well, they were pulling out all the stops they could with the plot and the story, some of which with the intent that, hey, if this is where it ends, we go out on a high note. Pretty cool and all that, but it did lead to some things that they probably weren't expecting to follow up on if they did. Now, to be fair, they did say that they left some of Shadow's backstory intentionally vague because there was also the chance that they could build up on his plot, but I'm willing to bet that their bets were more so on this is going to be our swan song, especially given a lot of the stuff that they do with this one. So in turn, the moon was going to be an awkward thing. However, here's a theory I have. Well, not so much a theory, but an observation. The moon thing was sort of an extension of when they were doing that stupid two worlds thing, essentially. Oh, why is the moon okay here? Well, we're on a different world. And guess what? I found out a little secret about that. Well, not so much a secret now that it's out in the open. See, Izuka did try to rationalize the two worlds thing, but that was only as a good will gesture towards the guy who insisted on that mandate. And you get free guesses as to who's the one who came up with the stupid two worlds thing in the get-go. You're not gonna guess?
Yuji Naka, come
congrats. On. Congrats, yes, Yuji Naka is actually the one we have to thank for that.
So he cares of- oh wow, that was cheap too.
Actually, to be fair, Omochao does warn you about that stuff falling. I just took a bit of time to get there. I will say this. I'm fine with Tails in the mech, but I do feel like compared to Eggman, he feels quicker but a bit more jittery at times.
Look at this. For example, this particular level. Story-wise, you can tell that Tails was added into the game in the later stages, right?
I did it, Sonic!
Because there's not really much of a plot reason for Tails to be going around the streets destroying things. You can just use a tornado into plane mode and go and fly away. Why are you even going through the entire city blowing shit up?
That's one thing I know some people take issue with. Why is Tails in the mech?
My take has always been that, we know the reason, make a counterpart to Eggman. As for story-wise why he would use a mech for the action, I can get that. Stuff's getting more serious, and Tails, while he is capable on his speed, does want to build up the firepower to match for Steph getting this serious. Oh, right, Aquatic Mine. One of the most chill and relaxing sounding raps, which is perfect for calming your nerves because this is one of the water levels.
Also, you can call it Aquatic Mine as much as you want, but you cannot fool me. I know what this is, a sewer level in disguise.
Okay. My advice with this level, always hit switch number 3, since that'll make it so that you have to deal with the least water possible. And, you know, sometimes water will help, but I assure you, 9 times out of 10, you're gonna... Okay.
It's also the level where you get the rebreather, don't you?
Yes. The thing is, though, 9 times out of 10, you'll find that the Emerald Shard is in, like, an enemy that you need to hit. The problem, you cannot attack while you are swimming. You can't even dig while you're swimming either. And yes, ghosts are aplenty here, and I love how one of the things you can dig out is one of the poor souls who died in this mine, which is probably why it's abandoned. But,
I get maybe not being able to dig, but not attacking underwater, it just feels kinda dumb.
Speaking of chill rap lyrics, we gotta talk about Knuckles' lyrics in Wild Canyon, because according to those lyrics, he's down bad for Rouge, since the lyrics
The story doesn't leave much to the imagination, if I had to be honest.
I kid you not. Some of the lyrics are literally how Rouge is sexy and smooth, how she's after his jewels, he'll get her with these tools, give up the emeralds and die, I totally don't love you.
Sheesh, there always seems to be a lot of police around when you don't need them.
What's the deal with that?
Wow, that's constantly Sonic. That's constantly.
And we're about to get the most famous mistranslation of the game.
Outer space. Outer space.
What are you, Solid Snake?
Ah, here we go.
Knuckles. Hey guys.
Hey, Knuckles.
Long time no see. Lost in the mines. Looking for the Master Emerald pieces was tougher than I thought it would be.
Yeah, listen to this upcoming line from Amy.
Where are we, anyway?
Where are you going?
Move aside, Knuckles!
Where are you going?
I managed going? To find the transcript
he's supposed
Eggman
to say, what are you doing?
So, let me get this straight. You were insistent on calling the shots with this translation, but you thought that translation was fine. Okay,
let's meet up there.
Does this game not have a retranslation mod like SA1 does?
Yeah, I mentioned that in first part, I think.
One of the mods I'm using does have the subtitles definitely different from what the characters are saying. So if I recall correctly, one of those is a retranslation.
Yeah, it's to accompany the Japanese voices.
And now Tails is literally having to chase the President of the United States in his limousine.
On an airborne road.
Translation mods for Adventure 1 and Adventure 2 do exactly that. They're a proper localization of the English script that we should, the Japanese script that we should have gotten in the first place if it wasn't for Nanko.
You were not kidding the other part. This city is bizarre. Now it is one of its highways suspended way above ground.
And yet
the sky.
And yet the funny thing is, this is Route 101. That is a legit highway that goes through San Francisco. That's right. We in America have revolutionized highway travel so much to the point where we only have highways that are roller coasters, but our highways are now literal racetracks up in the sky that everyone races on.
No wonder Sonic Team hated it.
Yeah. No, one thing that's important to mention is that while the PS2 was indeed one of the factors that killed the Dreamcast, it wasn't just that. It was also the fact that by the time the Dreamcast was about, Sega had destroyed a lot of their brand reputation through a lot of the stupid shit they pulled with the Sega CD and the PS2X.
And the Saturn.
And the Saturn. Let's not forget how they literally put the Saturn out without even warning the developers.
It's not even that. It was the arbitrary way of translating, releasing titles in the West, and also, if I have to be honest, depriving the West of the awesomeness that is the commercial with Sega the Sanshiro.
You know what's the sad part about that, by the way? You can check Kim Justice's video called "Sega in the Sega 1995." What the fuck is going on? Something along those lines. Kim Justice is a great YouTuber. Mm-hmm. So you should watch them anyway. You can watch their video about that particular happening at the launch of the Saturn. Originally, they actually had a plan to release the Saturn at a different date, and it was going to be a traditional launch where they would warn the developers and the stores properly, right? But someone decided, no, you know what? We're going to surprise everybody by just launching it all of a sudden with no warning. Even though and in hindsight, their original strategy was actually much better. They didn't. There's also the fact that the lack of a major Sonic game on the Saturn also hurt things a lot in the West.
What about Sonic 3D Blast?
The fact that a lot of titles just simply were not, properly released or had very little to no marketing, I'm confident if the marketing was done better, it probably would have managed to, be more of a decent, spanner in the works to the PS1.
Because Mr. President, there's a fox and a plane car following us.
Mr. President, reports show that since the incident
the design is clearly based on Bill Clinton.
Fitting, since apparently Bill... It's fitting because Bill Clinton was mentioned as one of the inspirations for Sonic.
His goddamn legs, bro.
Spare me the details. Exactly just what is it that you want? Dr. Eggman?
Well, let's just get down to business then, shall we, Mr. President? I won't bore you with all the details since I know you are a very busy
Dr. Eggman, I think your transmission signal is a bit...
You look like you have four arms.
Keep it very close. Remember, this is the 90s/early 2000s.
Need your world for that matter.
Well, he's gonna start country by country.
What the?
Hi, Sonic.
Hey.
Help her being attacked. Where's the Secret Service?
You don't mind if I make a little political interaction?
I have a question. Why would
Sonic, you need to stop becoming so political all of a sudden.
Why would the president's limo have a hole on the ceiling?
It just incited someone to throw a grenade.
It's a sunroof.
Where's the Secret Service?
Well, I get that, Shirai, but isn't that like a big security hazard that you have there?
Okay,
Shush.
Anyway, in regards to the Secret Service thing, the idea is that the president is going covert, which is why he's in a limousine in San Francisco instead of the White House, keep things hush-hush. The only reason we were even able to find him is because Tails is a genius and was able to track his signal in that regard, so they were going covert in that regard. But yeah, interestingly enough, it feels like while Sonic gets in on the negotiations, it seems that the president also has a certain agent who's reporting into him.
I wonder who could that be? Oh wait, we already know.
Or do we, since technically the president hasn't been mentioned before.
Right. Sure, it's me, the cat. See you for
He shows up in every stage, so why not? It's all part of his covert operation.
See ya.
See ya.